Hi friends, Simit here from informtrades.com. In this video, I want to review the AB equals CD pattern, a basic technical analysis pattern used to measure and trade trends. We'll review that and how traders can use it. Key points: it is a tool for measuring and forecasting trends. Basically, the way the indicator works, and we'll get into this later in the video, is there's 4 points you want to keep an eye out for, 4 points you want to draw on the chart, points A, B, C, and D. A to B is the first leg of the trend, B to C is the retracement, we measure the retracement using Fibonacci lines, and C to D is the next leg of the trend. The idea here is that the anticipated length of C to D is equal to the length of A to B. So C to D is really sort of the main trade opportunity that you're looking for with the AB equals CD pattern. Okay, it's easiest to understand a lot of this when looking at an example. So on the screen right now, you know, what you want to start, just like when you're measuring Fibonacci, and we have a video on Fibonacci, which definitely you'll want to check out if you're not familiar with that concept. The first step is to identify a trend. So right here on this on the screen right now, where the green line is, this first green line right here, we see that price clearly was at a base and then it shot up. Okay, so that's the first leg of the trend, and this is point A. You know, the start of that leg of the trend is A, then the top is B. When this candle comes in, we start to see retracement. So this gives us an idea of where to start looking for point C. Basically, A is the start of the trend, B is the top, and C is going to be where the trend reverses itself. Once A goes to B and you start to see it retracing, you can draw the Fibonacci retracement lines. And you can expect B to C to be from wherever B ends to a Fibonacci line. Often it's a 61.8 Fibonacci line, which is the deepest one or of the three most common ones. So, you know, A to B, and then you want to look for price to retrace to a Fibonacci line. Once it touches a Fibonacci line, you want to look for your reversal signs. It could be reversal candlestick patterns, supply or support resistance zone, 200 moving average, any of your standard signs that would also confirm that there'd be a reversal there. Okay, so here's A, then we go to the top B, then we measure the retracement using Fibonacci lines, and you know, it could be here, for instance, 61.8, that's the C. Now the length of A to B is the anticipated length of C to D. So for instance, this is a chart of gold. If we go from 1500 to over 1900, then we come back to 1650, we get an idea of where D can be. You know, base gives us a target of 24. A to B equals C to D. Let's look at another example that might make it a little bit easier to understand. Okay, once again, we see we have a base here. You know, A is trending, goes to B, we get a pullback. Here's C. C to D, the length of C to D is equal to A to B. So once you see this trend forming, you know, if you expect the trend to continue, you wait for the pullback, and then you can enter. Once you see, you know, pulls back and you see some signs of reversal, you can enter in the anticipation that, you know, C to D will equal A to B. So it gives you sort of a price target. When price reaches that target, you can then, you know, either take profit or look for some other confirming indicators. On the chart or on the screen right now is a chart shared by Informed Trades member DREBG. He observes that at point D, there's also a divergence, which is another cue that it may be time to exit. And then we start to see price show some weakness. We see what could be called a bearish checkmate. That's another cue to exit. That's sort of the basic idea. You know, if you have any questions or knowledge that you want to share, join us over at informedtrades.com. Thanks and best of luck in your trading.